Hello, in this lecture we will be seeing different types of temperature sensors, mainly RTD, thermistor and thermocouples. So let's start with RTD first. RTD stands for resistance temperature detector. Basically it is a resistance type temperature sensor. RTD is a temperature sensor whose resistance changes in proportion with its temperature. RTDs are passive type of sensors as they require external power supply for their operation. The resistance of metals increases with increase in temperature. Therefore, metals have positive temperature coefficient of resistivity. However, some semiconducting materials have negative temperature coefficient of resistivity. That means their resistance decreases with increase in temperature. The relation between resistance and temperature is given by RT is equal to R0 into bracket 1 plus AT plus BT square, where A and B are constants. RT is the resistance of temperature sensor at time T and R0 is resistance of sensor at room temperature. So let us now see different types of RTDs. So we'll be seeing platinum resistance thermometer, which is made up of metal material, and second type of RTD that we'll see is thermistor, which is made up of semiconductor material. So let us see first of all PRT. PRT stands for platinum resistance thermometer. It is basically RTD. The platinum wire is wound on this ceramic or mica material. This wire is in direct contact with the liquid or gas whose temperature is to be measured. PRT has positive temperature coefficient of resistivity. The variation in resistance of PRT is converted into corresponding voltage by connecting that PRT in Wheatstone's bridge. The voltage at point A is constant and is given by VA is equal to R3 by R1 plus R3 into VS. However, voltage at point B, it is proportional to temperature. The voltage VBA is a differential voltage, which is nothing but output of PRT. This output voltage, it is amplified by using a differential amplifier. PRT has wide temperature range. Its temperature range is from -200 degrees Celsius to 650 degrees Celsius. But PRT has low resolution. That is, for each degree Celsius change in temperature, the resistance of PRT changes by 7 ohms only. So this is one of the limitations of PRT. Next type of RTD is thermistor. Thermistors are also temperature dependent resistors, that is RTDs. They are made up of semiconductor materials which may have negative temperature coefficient or positive temperature coefficient of resistivity. They are made up of materials such as mixtures of sulfides, selenide oxides of manganese, cobalt, nickel, iron, copper, etc. They are available in various configurations such as small beads, here we can see, then discs and rods. So these are the various configurations of thermistors. And this is the symbol of a thermistor. The resistance of thermistor can be given by this formula. RT is equal to R0 into exponential of beta into 1 by T minus 1 by T0, where RT is the resistance at T degree Kelvin, R0 is resistance at room temperature. Now this equation shows that the variation in resistance is non-linear with respect to temperature. So we can see in this graph, variation of resistance is non-linear with respect to temperature. Also, as resistance decreases with increasing temperature, this thermistor has negative temperature coefficient of resistivity. The variation in resistance of thermistor due to changes in temperature are converted into corresponding voltage by using Wheatstone's bridge. So here we have connected thermistor and changes in temperature are converted into variation in resistance. And that variation in resistance is converted into corresponding voltage by using this Wheatstone's bridge. The output voltage is amplified by using the amplifier. Thermistor has very high resolution. This is in contrast with PRT. Means for each degree Celsius change in temperature, the resistance of thermistor varies with 80 ohms, which is very high. It was only 7 ohms for PRT. But the range is restricted, the temperature range is restricted for thermistor. It is from minus 100 degrees Celsius to 300 degrees Celsius, which is the limitation of thermistor. Now let us see one more temperature sensor, that is thermocouple. Thermocouple is active temperature sensor. So this is, thermocouple is different from thermistor or PRT, as PRT and thermistor were passive types of temperature sensors, whereas thermocouple is active temperature sensor, which means that it produces an EMF due to changes in temperature, and also it doesn't need any external power supply as it is active temperature sensor. Thermocouple is based on thermocouple operation is based on Seebeck effect. That is, Seebeck effect states that the current flows in a closed circuit made up of two dissimilar metals if the junctions of two metals are kept at different temperatures. Due to this current flow, an EMF proportional to temperature difference is produced. Consider X and Y are two dissimilar metals which are joined together to form two junctions J1 and J2. If these junctions are kept at different temperatures, let's say T1 and T2, then the output EMF, the EMF generated, is proportional to difference between T1 and T2. So E is given by K into T1 minus T2. So output EMF is proportional to temperature difference of two junctions, J1 and J2. In temperature measurement system using thermocouples, one of the two junctions can be maintained at a constant temperature. That is, it will be a reference junction, or you can say a cold junction. The reference temperature is 273 degree Kelvin or 0 degree Celsius. A millivoltmeter, it is connected to measure the thermally generated EMF. So this is the circuit for connecting thermocouple for measuring the temperature. Now there are different metals, metal alloys, which are used for thermocouples, and they have different temperature ranges. So this graph shows different types of thermocouples made up of different metal alloys and their corresponding temperature range. Overall, thermocouples have very wide temperature range. That is, they can measure temperatures from minus 200 degrees Celsius to 1100 degrees Celsius. That is why thermocouples are used in furnaces in industries. So in this lecture, we have seen temperature sensors. In that, first we have seen PRT, that is platinum resistance thermometer. Then we have seen thermistor, and lastly we have seen thermocouple. In next lecture also, we will be seeing again a new type of sensor. Thank you.